Does the gentleman move to strike the last word?
I move to strike the last word.
The gentleman is recognized for 5 minutes.
The gentleman who preceded me said we lost a lawsuit. We didn't lose a lawsuit. If he doesn't knows anything about the WTO dispute resolution process, no conflict of interest, no open litigation, no legal proceeding, as we in the United States of America understand it, a closed group with no conflict of interest rules that makes rulings. And they have decided that we, under this failed trade policy, should pay tribute more than we paid to the Barbary Pirates, $147,300,000 a year to the government of Brazil so we can subsidize our cotton farmers. Now you go home and explain that to your constituents. We'll borrow $147,300,000 from China and we'll send it to Brazil so we can subsidize our cotton farmers. What is this all about? It is about a totally failed trade policy. And at some point, this Congress has to take a stand. Ron Paul and I, a number of years ago, 3 years ago, we get to do it once every 5 years, offered an amendment to withdraw the United States of America from the WTO. That'll come up soon. I hope you'll all support it. It is something that binds us and is destroying our industries, our farmers, and everything else that's great about this country. I voted against the WTO. This isn't about so much as a failed farm policy or farm bill, as a gentleman outlined. It's about totally failed trade policies. Other countries want to protect their agricultural interests. They want to feed their own people. They don't want to import polluted food from China. We have opened up our country to polluted food and goods from China and Brazil and every place else in the world with the WTO and these trade agreements. They don't observe them. We go and we lose this dispute and say, oh, we've got no choice but to pay. We have a choice. Let's not pay. We're not going to pay the tribute. We're not going to borrow the money from China. We're not going to send it to Brazil. Let's see what they do next. And maybe we can blow up this thing called the WTO and get back to something that protects our national interests. With that, I yield to the gentleman from Wisconsin. Thank you.